Hello, my name is Benson from hatesmile.com, and today we are going to learn on PDO. So basically, PDO is just means PHP data object. So the first thing, let's just open our browser really fast. So I created a database called PDO. In this database, we are going to create a table that we are going to perform different operations in it. So basically, the first thing is to create a table, and of course, you know how to create a database. To create a database, just click new. Then write the name of the database. Since I have database, click it. Then name your table. Just name it something like PDO table. So the first variable must be ID, which must be auto increment, and index should be primary key. So the second thing, we can just say something like first name camocast, second name and password, so all an email. So we can use this data to perform different operations. The database, let's make it vulture and give it a default, the maximum length, it doesn't matter, it's just for learning purposes. So you go ahead and create the full table. So now that we have our table, in this tutorial we are going to learn basically how to connect to the database using PDO. I have created a folder in the htdocs and I've called it PDO. Inside this is where I'm going to create my file called index.php, and it is in the index.php whereby we are going to perform different operations. So I'm just going to name it index.php. So I have my index.php here, which I can open it with notepad++. So the first thing is to create the label php. We need to see if we are going to connect to the database. So the first thing is to define the server name. So I'm just going ahead and say server name. In our case, our server name will be localhost. So localhost. So the second thing will be to determine the we can go direct to the username of our database, or we can just go to db name. We can just call it. You can see our database name. If you come here, back here, you can see our data name. Our database name is PDO. So name it the same thing, PDO. So the second thing is to name the password of our database, or maybe username. Let me just first start with the username. In our case, with root. I'm sorry. And we can also name the our DB password, which can be nothing. So let's also call this DB username, so that we shall be able to define. Now we are using the PDO. To use the PDO, and basically, so this is just going to the database, but in the next tutorial I'm going to show you how to create a config file, and basically that's what we could have done right now. So we can copy paste everything here, we can cut it, and we create a config config.in.php that will be performing the database connection, so that we don't mix up the code. So config.in.php, and inside our config.in.php inside our config.in.php, this is where we want to paste our code, because you can see this is config.in.php. So you can just come in and say try, because this is a PDO, so we have to use the try, so that if anything goes bad, we can have some exception raised. So just come in and say a, and we can just come in and say die. So die a get message. Alright, so now how do you connect to the database using PDO? To connect to the database using PDO, we are just going to create a variable, PHP variable called con, or you can call it almost anything you want. The next thing is is to create a PDO. Generally, call is a PDO object. So we're just going to create the new our object, PDO object. You can say new PDO, and this PDO is a predefined class in the PHP, so you don't need to worry so much about it. And our PDO should take three parameters. So basically, the first one. The second parameter should always be DB username. DB username, and the third parameter should be DB password. Yeah. Now the main issue now is here inside our first parameter, because it contains some messy data here. So we just come here and say MySQL, put a full colon and say host equals to our server name. We have our server name. Let's, in PHP, you understand when we have the quotation marks, the double quotation marks, you don't need to concatenate your defined variable. So you can just name it the way it is inside the quotation mark, and it will be seen as a variable without no problem. So you can just say MySQL host equal to server name. Basically, then the next thing that we should do is to put a semicolon. And the next thing should be to define your database. So db name should be equals to our db name. Yeah, and I think that's what we need to connect to our database, and nothing more. Basically, the only thing that you should understand here in the PDO, when connected to the database, you should understand that something like MySQL is a predefined something in PHP or in PDO. Hosts, it's not something you're gonna change. This is something predefined, and we can call it as a syntax. Also, the bname is a syntax in the PDO, so it should look like that. But you also need, when you are handling the errors, but the first thing, let's see if everything went well before we put some messy things here. Let me, connection succeeded. So we can now come here to our, you know, we are in the config.php, so now we can come here and acquire in our index.php, we can come here and acquire our config.php, config.php there. And then we can try to load that in our browser. So it's localhost. Localhost, and our folder is PDO, so just we can see we have an error. Let's try to solve this error so that we can see where the problem is. Let's go back to a config.php and try to check out. So you can see, instead of writing root, we wrote root. So we can just put the root, you know, the username for the database. And you can see connection has succeeded. But now there's also another thing that we need to do in our using our objects here, so that we can be able to handle exception and errors thereafter. Errors when connected to the database, or when solving issues like you know, inserting, updating, and deleting. We need this. We need this line. You can say call set. We can say set attributes, it's written like that. And we can say PDO ATTR here mode. And you can also have PDO ATTR. Okay, sorry, it should be PDO EL mode. EL mode exception. I don't know if something like that. Let's just see if we're gonna everything working. If we don't, we can get rid of that, right? Yeah, connection succeeded. So everything is working nice, and that's how to connect to the database using PDO. So for this and more tutorials, check my blog post and the link in the, make sure you check the link in the video description. Also check the link, the first pinned comment of this video, so that you can get the full tutorial and code for this video. So goodbye. Thanks for watching.